What's going on, TW fans? Thomas here, bringing you this week's episode of What's New at Tackle Warehouse. Fantasy fishing is back. That is right. We are hosting our annual contest once again. This year, the prizes are bigger and better than ever, which is hard to believe because they were already giant prizes. But not only is the main prize even bigger, we're offering more than one prize. That's right, for each tournament, we will be awarding a prize pack to the top finisher of that tournament. So maybe you forgot to set your lineup for these first two MLF events that already happened. That's all right. Hope is not all lost. You can still jump into each tournament every week because the top finisher will be getting a prize pack of their own. So make sure you get your lineup locked for all those upcoming derbies. Speaking of upcoming tournaments, the 2023 Bassmaster Elite Series kicks off at Lake Okeechobee tomorrow. So make sure you get your lineup locked. Get it in, get set, get ready. I want to see you guys on the leaderboards. All right, that's enough about fantasy fishing. Let's talk real fishing here. We got some gear to go over. All right, we're going to start with a rod this time. We got a new one from Eagle Claw. We got the EC 2.5 Travel Spinning Rod. Killer spinning rod to take with you on the go, wherever you're going, whether you're just stashing it in the truck for those unexpected angling adventures, or if you're going to stash this thing in your pack on your next hike, or you're going camping for a weekend, whatever the case may be, this thing packs down real small. It's lightweight, but it's giving you big performance as well. So built on a 24-ton graphite blank, it's going to keep that lightweight, you know, portable package product here, but it's also going to be sensitive. And you're also not sacrificing any durability. We all know when we're hiking out there, you know, bumps, things happen. Maybe you fall, slip on your pack. Well, this thing isn't going to break. You got that nice, durable graphite blank on this thing. That's not going to let you down. You're not going to miss any of those subtle bites because it's still a nice blank. Topped with some C-guide stainless steel guides on this one, so you're gonna get nice, accurate cast, good casting performance, and then a comfortable grip down below here. Little hook retainer on the bottom, I like that as well. It's a bummer when they don't include it. And then the full cork handle, you know, nice classic look, just a solid killer stick that you're gonna definitely wanna add to your collection for my traveling anglers. And to get you to those places, it does come with a nice, durable PVC storage tube. And then if you really wanna pack the thing down small, you don't wanna haul that PVC tube around, they got you covered with a soft case as well. So they're giving you two cases and that travel rod that breaks in down into three pieces, so really small profile. You can take that with you wherever your angling adventures go. All right, now let's look at some baits. We got a couple new ones from Bill Lewis. First up, we're gonna look at a new jerkbait series from Bill Lewis. This is the Bill Lewis Scope-Stiks. So we have the 100 millimeter and the 120 right here. So you got a couple different size options to choose for. It does not end there. Make sure you head over to tacklewarehouse.com because I mean, you can really cover every section of the water column in this thing. It goes from like 2 foot all the way down to 10 foot plus with their sinking models. So they have suspending, sinking, like I mentioned, and also floating models. So you really can cover the entire water column with these. So let's talk a little bit about them. So Scope-Stik is in the name. These things are actually built to cater to any of the guys running those live sonar units. So you can see you have this large surface area that's really flat. So it's gonna show up on your live sonar units really well from a long way out. So if you're dealing with kind of, you know, wary, spooky fish, you can cast this thing a real long ways and it's still gonna show up on your sonar unit nice and easy. So in addition to that wide body on the side, they also have a specially built bill on the front. So this thing is gonna really give erratic side to side, almost walk the dog motion underwater. And what that's gonna kind of aim to do is just keep the side, the profile of this bait, facing your front-facing sonar unit. So it really does show up the whole time. You can watch the bass come up and smoke your jerkbait underwater. Pretty cool new concept. But look, if you're not running those live sonar units, I'm certainly not. Those things are real expensive. This thing is still just a killer jerkbait all around. So I like that body profile to it. It does look pretty bait fishy. I know that it is purpose-built for that live sonar unit, but just that profile in general, I like it. I like that wide body to it. Got killer must-add triple grips on this thing, so you're getting great hardware and components right out of the package. And then just a ton of detailing. These oversized eyes that I really like. Great color schemes, a bunch of detailing. You know, you got the gill plates on the side here, mandibles up front, even got a couple of nostril holes on there. So just a really accurate, anatomically lifelike jerkbait that you're gonna wanna check out, especially if you're using the live sonar units. But if not, it's still a killer jerkbait. So we're not done there with Bill Lewis. We also have their new ATV series of square bill crankbaits. So this one, again, is gonna be available in a bunch of different sizes. Well, we have a 1, 1.5, and 2.5. So I guess just the most important sizes for the square bill. And then they're gonna dive a couple of different depths. So still gonna be a shallow water square bill, but ATV is in the name. All-terrain vehicle, and that's exactly what this thing is built to do. It's built to crash and bulldoze its way through a bunch of different cover, kind of send it to where you wouldn't send a traditional square bill bait. So they built this one to kind of fill out their crankbait lineup. So you really are gonna be able to come through boulders, come through grass really well. If you're dealing with some laydowns, you're gonna be able to come through all that stuff really well. So you're gonna get tremendous action out of this thing. It's gonna come through the cover nice, and you're also gonna get kind of those unique sonic vibrations that we've come accustomed to from, you know, Billows' rattle traps. So they've just been legendary for that sonic vibration that really calls to the fish. Well, you're gonna get it in the square bill as well. So it's got a little bit of noise to it too, so it's really gonna call in those predators. Again, we got triple grip hooks right out of the package, so you don't need to swap these things out. And killer paint schemes. So if you want to check this one out, add it to your arsenal. If you find yourself fishing in some of those snaggier places, pick up the ATV, all-terrain vehicle square bill, so you can send this thing where you wouldn't normally send them. All right, let's slip ourselves above the surface here. We got some topwater lures to talk about. We got one from Team Ark. We got the Z-Pop Popper. So this is just a cool Wes Logan designed popper. I mean, it's a killer little bait. I love fishing topwater. I know it's a little early in the season, but it's never too early to start thinking about it. But the popper system is great. You know, if for kind of smaller, maybe finicky fish, or if they're preying on smaller forage, which is what I was kind of alluding to before, this is really going to be key for that one. So in addition to its cool, accurate profile, it has a unique sound to it as well. Kind of almost like a single knock to it. So what it is, you have two BBs anchored on either side, and then you have a free rotating BB on the interior of this thing. So you're going to get really long casts out of it, but you're also getting that unique sound that you just heard there. It's just really nice. It's kind of mimicking a distressed bait fish. So this will actually sit tail down in the water, but as soon as you twitch that rod, it's gonna rock forward, spray a bunch of water, and you're gonna get that knocking sound to it. In addition to that profile I talked about, killer detailing on this one, great colorways, and then these really slick treble hooks on there, feather dressed in the back. So again, just another nice hard bait you're not gonna have to swap the hardware out on. You're definitely gonna wanna check out that popper from Team Ark. All right, staying above the surface here. We got a frog. Again, I know frog season is a little bit away from most parts in the country here, but I mean, when you're getting ready to load up on these things, this is gonna be one that you're gonna wanna add to your collection. So from Scum Frog, we have the Launch XS Frog. So you may be familiar with the Launch series of frogs from Scum Frog. Wildly productive frogs. I mean, they're super, super soft. They collapse really well, so you're gonna really increase your hookup ratios on this. Well, the difference with the XS series is it's just smaller. So that smaller, again, if the bass are keen in on smaller forage, you're fishing pressured waters, which seems like every water is pressured nowadays, you might wanna tone it down to a little bit smaller presentation. Well, you can do that with the Launch XS Frog. Now, kind of one challenge that you typically find with smaller frogs is they're really lightweight, they're hard to cast. Not the case here. So Scum Frog has their innovative proprietary parasite weight system. So there's actually a tungsten weight on the interior of this frog, welded to the hooks themselves. So you're getting a ton of extra weight on the inside of the frog, and you also have a brass button weight on the bottom of the frog, so this just means you're gonna cast this thing a long ways. It's gonna sit kind of tail down in the water, but it's still really balanced, so as soon as you start twitching your rod, it's gonna come up to that nice horizontal presentation and walk super, super easily. As I mentioned earlier, the body itself really, really collapsible to increase those hookup ratios, and they have a digitally printed pattern on these things, so you're getting really accurate, anatomically accurate, color schemes on these things. So really nice looking frogs that perform super well. Now you got a downsized platform. So definitely want to check that one out. Can't talk about frogs without talking about braid. Got a new one from Buddha Baits. We got the Buddha Baits Enlightened series of braid. Killer new braid that I'm excited to try out for a couple of reasons. One, the color on this thing is killer. It's kind of a really, really natural, almost OD green vibe to it, kind of a little bit brown in there as well, so just really, really camouflage. So if you're working this thing, that frog over some, you know, vegetative, cheesy mats, you know, it's just gonna blend in really well to that. Maybe you're just flipping, pitching into heavier cover. It's just gonna really blend in and hide itself, disguise itself well underwater. It doesn't just end there with the looks though. I mean, this thing's gonna give you great performance too. It's braid, you're gonna get zero stretch out of it. And it's made with 8 Japanese fibers, so you're getting that 8 weave braid. So really nice round braid. It's not gonna dig in as much. Just gonna feel really nice. You're not gonna feel any of the woven fibers in it as you're running your hands along this thing. It's a really nice quality braid. Also finishes with a little coating on the exterior of it. So you're gonna get, you know, supple, quiet cast. It's gonna come off the spool, almost jump off the spool really well. So you're gonna get long casts with this thing as well. So definitely a cool new braid. Comes in a 328-yard spool on this one. So you're getting plenty of line on this thing too, and it's not overly expensive. So definitely one you're gonna wanna try out for this frogging season, flipping, pitching, beyond. Any type of braid system that you wanna use, check it out. Maybe you like using braid with your vibrating jigs. Speaking of, we got one of those here. So new from Strike King, we have the Strike King Tungsten Thunder Cricket. Just about everyone's gotta know the Thunder Cricket by now. It's a killer vibrating jig, responsible for a ton of fish and big fish to boot. Well, now we're getting a tungsten profile. So if you wanna downsize your presentation, again, maybe your pressured waters, ultra clear reservoirs, anything like that, where you wanna downsize that presentation, but you don't wanna sacrifice the weight, Well, now we got a tungsten option to choose from here. So nice compact design, but still maintaining that heavier weight, so you're gonna get great castability out of this thing. Killer bait, so it's gonna give you that same action that we've come accustomed to, really fall in love with the regular Thunder Cricket. You know, constant steady vibration from the initial, you know, wind in your reel all the way back to the boat that really calls those fish in. You're getting all those same great features and killer action, but now you're getting a downsized tungsten version. Cool painted blade on this one here. So if you're looking, you know, like I said, dealing with some ultra clear water reservoirs or whatever reason you want to downsize that presentation, but still get that crazy big action, check out the Tungsten Thunder Cricket. All right, got a couple of more baits to look at here. This one is from Fishlab. This is the Fishlab Nature Series Frog. So just kind of a cool little creature bait. You know, if you're tackling some waters where your bass are chasing a bunch of amphibians, this is a great amphibian imitator here. So it's got a little frog body to it. Maybe you're trying to imitate some tadpoles or just a little frog itself. This is a good one to start with. So a ton of stuff going on in this body. First of all, it's pretty accurate. So you got some eyes molded up here. We got some ribbing on the body to grab, push a little bit of water. And then you get down here, you get kind of these segmented legs that come out to all these little ball points where the toes are. So it's just gonna give you a ton of action. Out of the packaging, the legs are gonna come together, but you can absolutely split the seam down the middle, and you're gonna get some independent kicking action. A little bit more lifelike, just a little bit more, you know, calling power to those bass. So if you're dealing with heavier cover that you're pitching this thing into, it's just gonna call out to those bass, gonna allow them to locate this thing visually a little bit better. Got a couple of arms on the top here. Again, just some auxiliary action, and this thing is loaded with salt too. So when they do come in, taste this thing out, they're gonna hold on to it a little bit longer, and it's gonna add, give you a little bit of a weight to it as well. So you're gonna be able to pitch this thing a little bit easier. Little cavity, a little channel on the top of the body here to hide your hook point, you know, just keep it a really nice weedless tight presentation. So if you're looking for new flipping bait, new pitching bait, if you want to throw this thing on the back of Carolina rig, Texas rig, whatever you want, ton of things you can do with this one. Check it out from Fishlab. All right, last thing I want to talk about, a lot of salt on that one. Got a new kit from Chompers. We have the Chompers football jig kit. So a cool little kit for anybody that's maybe just thinking about dipping their toes in the water of bait customization, bait creation. If you want to start thinking about maybe is jig making right for me, well, this little handy kit is going to allow you to do just that. Also, it'll just allow you to customize your presentation to whatever water you're fishing. So it's going to come with a bunch of these football style heads, varying in size on them. They all have must-add ultra point hooks, so you're getting killer hardware out of the package. Full-size weed guards that you can trim down to your need, you know, to suit whatever vegetation level you're dealing with, whether it's heavy cover, light cover, sparse cover, you can trim that weed guard up to make it fit your needs. Comes with a bunch of different colored skirts on here, so you can add a bunch of them on there on different weights, or you can use the same hook, swap them out to suit your needs, and then you have some trailers right in there as well. So like I said, if you're looking to dip your toes into lure customization, or you're just looking for an all-in-one kit that's gonna allow you to cover darn near every situation that you're gonna find on the water that you wanna tackle with the jig, check out this kit from Chompers. All right, guys, that's gonna wrap up this week's episode of What's New at Tackle Warehouse. As always, thank you for tuning in and checking out these new products with us. And as always, to shop for them or to learn more about them, make sure to click the link in our description. If you wanna see more videos just like this one, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and let us know in the comments which one of these you're excited to use, and make sure to sign up for our fantasy fishing. All right, we'll see y'all next week.